So, you got access to Wrike. Congratulations. What now? Before you dive in, familiarize yourself with the basic structure of a Wrike workspace, or what we love to call the four building blocks of Wrike: spaces, folders, projects, and tasks. Spaces are central hubs that organize your work under a common goal or theme. Do you want to organize your space by team, function, type of work, or client? You can create a private space shared only with specific teams or individuals, or a public one that anyone in the account can search for and join. Organize your space with folders and subfolders to group all related tasks or projects. A marketing team would create folders to store their website or social media content projects. Folders and spaces are purely organizational. Tasks and projects, however, are for managing work and tracking progress. Projects group related tasks to achieve a bigger goal or initiative. For example, create a project for a blog launch and other initiatives. Tasks and subtasks are the smallest action items. In the blog launch project, you would create tasks for researching topics, writing content, and publishing the post. Tasks help you focus on what needs to be done to achieve your goal. Successful tasks and projects need to have four main attributes added: a clear, meaningful title, an assignee, a start and due date, and a status that reflects the actual work progress. Keep in mind that by default, sharing cascades down. When you share a space, you automatically share all the folders, projects, and tasks within it, including any subfolders and their respective tasks. The same applies to individual folders or projects. Sharing them means sharing all the items they contain. Now you know the Wrike basics. Ready to transform your workspace?